Hey guys, it's SMG here, and today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on Age of Mythology. This is just going to be like a basics control tutorial, how to play. I made this map myself. If you guys want to learn how to make maps and stuff, that's a different tutorial that I made, editor tutorial. But anyways, let's get started. So, for the basics tutorial, I will be teaching you what is the best way to get food, what you should do with gold in the beginning, wood, and just basics as it is. I'm not the best at Age of Mythology, but I know how to get a quick start. I'm not very good with strategies, I guess is how you say. But this is basically for the noobs, so don't get mad at me if you already know all this stuff. Alright, so basically, first what you're going to want to do, you're going to want to hurry up and get food. And there's multiple choices for food in the beginning. You have farm animals, that's what I would call them. And then you got huntable animals. Huntable animals will give you food faster than farm animals will. And what you basically want to do first is get the huntable animals if they're close. If you don't have any close, it'd probably be better if you just got the farmable animals. And goats are farmable animals too. Berry bushes, I'm not really sure about them. I think they're pretty good to get. And right off the bat, you're going to want to make as many villagers as possible. So put this on, and this will make it repeat so the villagers come out. So you select this first, you select this, and it'll make it repeat on its own. So the villagers will just keep on coming out on their own. As you can see, it's going to happen. And stick it. There you go. See? Now, they'll just repeating. As long as there's food there, if it runs out of food, it'll stay there until you have enough food to make another one. Just to cancel it, you just click right there. Alright. Now, there's no one attacking me today, but there is a base over there. And another thing that you want to do, if you hold down shift and right click, you can have them so it explores multiple areas for you. Like this. But an easier way to do this is just right click on your minimap. So you don't have to take as long to explore. Alright, so after you get out, basically the order that you should go into is you should get food first, and then when you're heading into the second age, you should get wood. Wood is very important in the second age because you can create buildings, and that's pretty much mostly what you're going to be doing in second age. This is mostly for Greek, though, but if you were Egyptian, to say, you would try to get gold second, because everything in Egyptian takes gold. Norse, I'm pretty sure they're pretty similar to Greek, but I don't play them a lot. Atlantean, you pretty much want everything, probably food and wood first, just like the Greek. As you can see, I'm discovering this out here. You want to make sure your guy doesn't die, but these guys are probably going to follow him to his death. But that's okay, because I already discovered most of the map anyway. And you want to treat every unit like... You don't want any unit to die, what I'm saying. If you have one villager die, that could be a way for your enemy to beat you, and you don't want that to happen, obviously. Alright, so I'm going to send this guy on a wood... Also, if you could build a granary at first, that would be helpful, and then get the upgrades on it for hunting. It will help you hunt faster. Here, I'll just build one to show you. Alright, so I'm going to start hunting these elk here, because they're running out of deer. Alright, so you want to try to starting off as fast as possible. I'm going to start hunting these, not hunting, but farming these. And as you can see, there's more out here, but get the stuff that's close to your base as possible, if possible, because then, because it doesn't take as much time to get out there. And rhinos would not be a good idea to try to hunt, because they could kill your villager and set you back some. Also, it distracts your villager a little while because of how long it takes to kill. Rugs, I'll get to those in just a minute, but basically what you want to do is just hunt as much as you can first, farm. Then next thing you want to do is build a temple after you get 400 meat. It doesn't matter if you build the temple first or not, but I prefer getting 400 meat first, about 400 meat, then building a temple, because then I know I'm safe. Also, here's the hunting things, hunting dogs, whatever that says. Herd animals faster, herd animals fatter, faster. Villagers carry more food gather from herded animals. Also, if you want to know what something does, just right-click on it and I'll tell you. Like, villagers gather food from hunted animals faster. sorry, guys. This will be, like, deer, elk, rhinos, anything that it takes to shoot with arrow. This is farmed animals, like these guys, elk, I mean, not elk, cows, pigs, goats. Excuse me. And so basically selecting your god is, if you look at your opponent, it's the best way, but if I would usually choose Hades, so I usually choose whoever has the Cyclops, I don't know what the god's called, because they're good at rushing, but right now I'd probably pick the Minotaurs. Now I'm still gonna get some food. Oh yeah, you can't forget about building houses. Okay, say you have a sentry towers around, then you're gonna wanna put houses around them. I can't give you an example yet, but if you put the houses around the sentry towers, it'll give you protection, your sentry tower protection, and it'll give your houses protection. Then they're just not there in the open, and open for attack. Also, if you were going to attack, go for the houses first, so they can't redo their population. Houses and villagers are very important to attack. You should attack the houses first, then the villagers, because then they can't produce any more villagers. And which would just screw them over. Right there, and then, alright, don't have enough gold, so what you guys are going to need to do is get some wood and gold. Alright, build, we don't have enough wood yet. Alright, now you can start farming if you want to, and this is an upgrade for the farming, but obviously can't afford it yet, so, see the Minotaur, it's, if the AI was on for this guy, because it's a custom built map, I don't have his AI on. But if it was on, say it was a Minotaur or Cyclops, it'd be good to go and distract their villagers and try to attack one of their gold mines or something, just to get them from not producing villagers as fast or getting an army faster than you. If they got an army faster than you, if they attack first, it's good to upgrade your hit points. Which is this, improves hit points of buildings, makes them more resistant to crush and attacks such as siege weapons. So let's say they attack first, then you're gonna want to put more of a defense up, because if you're booming, which booming is getting a lot of resources and not attacking as fast, then it's a good idea to build up your defense. If you're not building and you're trying to rush them, it's a good idea to get the fastest army you can and then attack. But I don't know what strategy is better. I guess it's just all on yours. But let's say that I'm playing 3v3 and I'm in the middle. I have one teammate right here and one teammate right here. And I'm in the center. It's good to boom. But if I'm on the outskirts, it's good to rush. You want to keep your middle guy protected, especially if he's booming, because he'll provide you with the big armies, and you should defend him. Now that my resource production is beginning, I can build one of these. Probably should get some farms started. The good thing about farms, you don't have to worry about them, so you don't have to keep them coming back. But it's always good to have the other forms of getting food too. Also, there's fishing, which is better than farming because you don't have to put your villagers to task. And they usually don't go for your fishing ships if they don't have docks. So, all right, so it's good to get your Cyclops upgraded or your Minotaurs. And then upgrade to Minotaur to Bull Minotaurs, which are cheaper and more powerful. That would be a very good upgrade. If you're gonna try to go with mythical units, then you should get someone to worship. I don't know why I wasn't. All right, should build a gold mine closer. Get some more miners. All right, so what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna upgrade both of these. This one's for the pickaxe, obviously, for the gold. This one's the axe for the wood. Makes it so you can gather wood and carry more gold faster and carry more gold. Now, I should start getting more on food because eventually I'll start not having enough to produce more villagers. And I also want more houses because you can't. That's like the number one thing I always figured about is building houses. But you need to remember to have enough for your villagers and for your army. And normally by this time they would already have an army produced, and you would be screwed. But this isn't a real game, so you'd be okay. Okay, let's get some more on there. This is for gold. This is for wood. We'll just gather wood faster and carry more. Okay. More food is needed. I'm not. You should really have it more balanced than I do. I have them all on wood, but wood's a very good thing to have because you can build towers, but especially if you want to be defensive, you need a lot of wood and gold. If you're going on an attack, you need food and gold, not really wood. But it's always good to have wood. It's always good to have every resource, I should say. Also, you should start sending villagers, even if it's just one, to start worshipping, because when you're not watching, it'll go up, and it has a maximum of 100. So I wouldn't put too many on there, unless you're wanting to have a whole bunch of mythical units. See, with the Egyptians, you had to build a monument, but we're not playing Egyptians, so all right. I'm just doing this for all the people that don't know. So I know it took me a while to learn how to play the game properly without being that much of a noob. So I just thought that other people would probably need help. And when other people call people noobs, it's stupid because everybody was once a noob. But I guess they just get their time to shine as a non-noob because everybody has to learn once in a while. And when you call someone a noob, they're not going to be able to learn because they're not going to want to play if you keep on making fun of them. I don't. That's just how I see it, at least. Also, I want to show you guys something. This is a small gold mine, medium and large. This one has the least gold and medium, and you understand. But that's just something you should look out for when you're going looking for gold mines. If you run out at your house, I could probably kill the opponent right now. I'm building walls for defense, a quick defense, because I don't need to put walls all around my base. I just need to put it in the front. And I'm kind of, if I were in a, I'm. If I were in a real game right now, I'd be playing on a defense because the walls, and obviously, and you would want to build towers. We need more gold, need more food. Build a tower. So you would want to put the houses around the tower like this, because it really helps. So if I'm going to be playing on the defense, I'm going to want to build that. I mean, buy that, and that will increase the hit points on my buildings and walls and towers, which is very good for playing a defensive. Now the thing about playing a defensive is that you wanna wait till the perfect time to strike your opponent. But right now, I already told you there's no AI, so it doesn't really matter. Because this is just a tutorial. But after this, I'll show you some counter, some strategies, but what units counter and stuff. Basically, how it works is like a rock, paper, scissors situation. The Minotaur is a mythical unit. The Hoblet is a human unit. And the mythical units always are stronger than the human units. But the heroes are stronger than the mythical unit. It's like a rock, paper, scissors. So the Hoblet human unit would be able to attack the heroes, these two units, with higher attack. And that would be better against them. Heroes are pretty expensive, and would be a very good idea against someone that uses a lot of myth units. If you're just using human units, then you're gonna die. And say you're sometimes villagers get stuck in walls and stuff, which is very annoying. Instead of destroying the whole entire wall, you should just delete that villager, just create a new one. Now that it's part of the game. So by this time, you probably got attacked twice, and if you survived it, it would be good. Build some towers around your base. Now, you could spam these towers, or you could get an army ready to attack, which would probably be the best idea. So, now would be a good time to stop producing villagers. They're already done. But sometimes when you produce units, it stops for random reasons, which I don't understand, but there's bugs in this game. But that's okay. And you're going to want to build some more houses. Build houses around your towers. Not in front, though, because that's where they're going to be attacking. Right. So, you're going to want to build some houses around here. Alright, also you're going to want to upgrade your infantry with armor upgrades like this, with more hit points and attack, which is very good. This will improve their hack armor, I guess. I don't know why they put a spear in the picture for that, but that's very good. And even more houses, just max out your houses whenever you can. Also, the more town centers you have, the more population you can have. Buying that hit point thing now. You can upgrade your walls right here, or anywhere on the walls, actually. The gates are weaker than these walls, so make sure to have a minimum of gates, unless you really need them. I wouldn't recommend building towers like this. I put one over here and one right here, but that was just for example. Also, keep on building those houses around those towers and around the other buildings. I just upgraded the towers over here. This one upgrades line of sight for towers, and this one upgrades that now it can shoot arrows and have damage. This one makes it more hit points for, I wonder if, buildings, which is very good. Okay, now you're going to want to upgrade the second age. The second age building is this one right here. And it's the armory. Once you have the armory, then you can upgrade the second age, which is any one of these. By now, you probably should have attacked, but I'm going to show you how to attack in just a minute. Alright, so unless you're booming and defense, then you might be okay. But you have the choice between manicores, these upgrades right here, Hydra, or these upgrades. I prefer the Manticore because it has the Underworld upgrade. which you can spawn, you can teleport, I guess you would call it,
Μάλιστα.
and
Ετήσιος, λέγε.
you can end up behind the enemy units without them even knowing.
Λέγε, έστω, έστω. Βούλομαι.
It works very well most of the time.
Πρόσταγμα.
Alright, say you wanted to hunt these rhinos right here. They're very strong, so you have to be careful. I'll just show you what I mean.
Πρόσεχε.
See, even with all those guys attacking, I almost killed that
Ετήμασε.
villager right there. Just one of
Ετήμασε.
them.
Λέγε, έστω, έστω.
Alright. So you should probably, okay, you should do what you did with the villagers earlier, which actually upgrade your farms and upgrade your wood supply. You don't really need these unless you're in the beginning, but you don't really need those. All right, so click that to re to make it sure make it so it reproduces units faster. And I'm just gonna have one on for now, because I don't have that much food that is being produced. I'm gonna build another one of these right there, get some more food. All right, now to get to the third age, you're gonna need to build a market, which I would recommend building these far away, because I'll show you in just a minute. I'm just gonna build this right here, even though it might not be the best placement, but it's okay. Also, what you're gonna want to do is upgrade your guard towers, only if you're playing on the defensive. If you're playing on the attack, then you're not gonna need to upgrade your towers unless you're building close to their base. All right, so upgrade this. This will make it so it shoots more arrows and more damage. This will make it so if it's right next to them, that they'll they can the towers can attack them even if they're right next to them. All right, so this army is probably not gonna be good enough even for just the town center. So you might want to build or get some more warship first, but this is a fortress, and you're gonna want a fortress if your enemy has walls up like I do, because then you have cannon bolts, and just units to destroy building. All right, so and also if your enemy creates a titan, it's a good idea to use the cannon bolts and stuff. Now, this whole game is like rock, paper, scissors, so even though the Minotaurs counter the hoblets or the humans, and then the heroes counter the Minotaurs, and the humans counter the heroes, there's still even more rock, paper, scissors. Can't see what I did there, but so basically, if you have archers, they're good against the hand attack soldiers. If you have horses, they're good against archers, and the foot soldiers are good against horses. It's just a big game of rock, paper, scissors.
Μάλιστα. Ναι, μάλιστα.
That's how I like to think of it anyways. So you probably should get this upgrade it in the one that's not doing anything first. And this will upgrade their armor and their pierce armor. The pierce armor is basically from archers like this one, and I'm gonna start producing more army now. And now I got a new myth unit. It's it shoots arrows out of his tail, or I think they're arrows, I don't know for sure. All right, so I think that I would have enough to attack now. I'll show you guys more what I mean about the rock, paper, scissors thing in just a minute if you don't understand yet. Right, so I'm just gonna go and attack their base, and I'll show you. Actually, I won't attack them yet. Wait just a minute. I'll attack these guys. So if you build a fortress, it's really good against buildings. Well, I mean, the stuff that you can produce against it. out of it is really good against buildings, but it takes a long time to build. So I'd recommend putting more than one villager on it. Even though I do that to most of my buildings, just put one on there. Put more than one on. And clicking up here will show you villagers that aren't work. So say he's just standing around. You can click right here, and it'll take you right to him. So you can see what villagers aren't at work. Alright, so I have more army coming up, being produced, even though I don't have to do anything to produce them. Alright, so that will show you where your heroes are at. It's kind of useful, I don't use it a lot, but it helps me find my army if I can't find them. Because sometimes I lose my army somehow, I don't understand how, but I do. Upgrade, keep on upgrading those resources. You don't need these two again unless you're hunting still, which I don't know who would be hunting. Upgrade those farms. Now, donkey caravans, they're good if you have long-lasting games, but if you don't or you can't find any gold, it's good to send them to the town center, and it will trade gold for you, so you can steadily get an income of gold. But the farther you have this away from your town center, the more you're going to make money. So a good spot to place it would be all the way up here on the edge of the map. Not behind their base, though. Like, say, over here or over here. The farther you can get it away, the more money. Okay. We're going to need some more. This is a very good upgrade to get. It upgrades the hit points, and it makes it so you get an extra 5 population from each town center. And which is very, very good. This is one of the upgrades that I get every time. So, after that, I could destroy them really easy right now. Probably with just these guys. No. Probably need a couple more guys, but I want to show you. If you have just villagers laying around, it's good to just delete them. So you can have extra population for other things. And alright. So now that you got the market, you can upgrade your town center. Or you need 1,000 meat, of course, first. But once you get 1,000 meat, you can upgrade your town center. So you can get the final age, finally. And you have a choice. If you're Zeus, you have the choice between Medusa, which is Hera, or I can't pronounce that name, which is Colossus. Colossus is good against the buildings. Medusa is good against units. Very, very, very efficient against units. So, right now I want to choose Colossus because I'm trying to fight a building. But it doesn't really matter on this level because I'm just facing AI. Or I'm not. The AI is not even on for their unit. So I really want this cannonball, so I'm going to delete these units so I can make space for it. Alright, now cannonballs are very overpowered against buildings, and to make them even more overpowered, you can increase their speed so they're not lagging behind everything else, which is an occurrence that happens all the time. And I'll just show you how overpowered they are against buildings. If he can ever get there. See, the town center can't even reach him. And they might not even notice that you're attacking their town center. Now, if they have soldiers, it's good to have this guy behind as far as possible you can get away and attack your soldiers with this. With your army. Soldiers and villagers. See, they're chasing the villager around. And then after you got all that done, you can just tell them to attack the town center or the buildings if they have no more units left. Alright, and I won. Oh yeah, I got an achievement. Alright, so that was the beginning. I'll show you some other tips and tricks. Alright, so I was in the game editor. Don't mind any of this up here. I'm just gonna show you guys some stuff. Alright, I'm just gonna delete that right there. I'm gonna delete all this. Delete. Alright. So let's say you have 3 units. A mythical unit, a human unit, and a hero. This is why I'm saying it's for like rock, paper, scissors. And you have on the other team, you have, hold on, I changed teams. Don't pay attention to any of this down here, just pay attention to up here. You have X-Men, which is a human unit. And then you have why can't I find it? Hold on. Oh, let's use automaton. You have an automaton, which is a mythical unit. And then you have another hero. Now, I said that these guys could take down heroes, but the heroes, like 90% of the time, have more attack. So I'll spread these out so they won't get in the same fight together.
Boring.
And I'll show you guys what I mean. Alright, so now I'm just gonna put a lighthouse behind him so you guys can see what's going on. Put one right here too. Yeah, went over here. Okay. So as you guys can see, hero, myth unit, and human unit. It's good to use the myth units against the human units. It's so much more powerful than human units. Use the hero units against the myth units.
Malista. Is machine.
A lot more powerful. And I still have these two units left. Use human units against hero units. This guy will probably kill him. But if you do it right, then you'll still have these units to attack him. Also, they say use human units against hero units because they're a lot cheaper and they'll probably be surrounding this guy. Wow. It's gonna take days.
Etimus. Etimus.
Yeah, but you guys get my point. Alright. Now I'm going to show you.
Etimus.
Human units. Talk. Toxitos for archers. Hoblite for hand attack units. And then no. I forgot what the Hibikins for the horseback, if you want to call it that. Alright, so I'll do the same thing for the other team, except team 2. Not Archer, Toxitos. It begins. Probably, actually. Right. Now Sam team one, and this is how I'm gonna wanna do it. All right, so horses are good against archers. Foot
Hetimos.
soldiers are gonna get horses, and
Prostagma.
archers are gonna against foot you hand attack units.
Lege. Kalos. Lege. Pani. Kalos. Prostagma. Isvoli.
Oh, they're gonna go after one each other.
Prostagma.
Yeah, let me restart that for you guys. Just get them farther away. Sorry about that. Okay, now I'll show you guys what I mean.
Hetimos. Isvoli. Hetimos. Isvoli. Lege. Isvoli.
Ah, oh, come on. Stupid. Okay, attempt three, guys.
Lege. Ismachin. Hetimos. Poro. Hetimos. Isvoli.
Oh my God. Well, I guess soldiers the best during the beginning, but that's how it's supposed to work. That's how they're supposed to be countered. Because the horses are faster than the archers, so they can come in right away and attack them. And then the foot units are slow, so the archers have a advantage over them because they can start attacking. But I guess this only accounts if you have them upgraded in the armory. Plus, I'm using Zeus, so he has advantage on something. I'm not really sure, but yeah, that's pretty much that, guys. I don't think I showed you the correct way, but that's pretty much how it is. I think that is all. Well, see you in the next video. Bye.